I just have one quick question. You know, we hear that maybe 1,000 times a day, and if we didn't, I think each and every one of us would, that would concern us, because that's what we're there for.
Okay.
3.5 years ago, I was conducting aerodynamics research at a wind tunnel, and through that research, we were able to significantly enhance the capabilities of wings. The machine shop was integral to that process because I had to basically build and then test and build and test and build and test.
Our project this semester is an automatic guitar tuner and player. So we have 6 servo motors down here that are in charge of plucking the strings, and 6 servo motors up here attached to tuning attachments, which automatically turn the pegs for you.
We're absolutely convinced in engineering that the bulk of the creativity for these things comes from the engineering innovations that occur because of people having exposures to places like the machine shop, where they can see this sandbox of creative capability.
Learning by doing is probably one of the most essential experiences you're going to get in here, because it integrates the theoretical that you learn in the classroom with the practical of how it's done out in industry.
It's easy to, in your CAD program, to make everything that it has 5 decimal places of tolerance, but for them to actually physically go in the shop and try to meet that standard, it gives them a whole new appreciation for kind of the physical reality of it.
So there are a few parts that I had to machine to within 0.5 to 1,000th precision. There's no real way to calculate that. It comes down to a lot of touching and feeling and experience.
You become immersed in what you're machining, and I think for a lot of our engineering students, it may be the first time they ever experience that physical contact with what they're making, and you can see it in their eyes.
Keep it going. Real fine tolerances and real fine size, you sneak up on it so we don't go past it.
Getting down into the shop here, working with those materials, is really what gives them the insight into the usefulness, and it's almost the art of the technical aspect of it. And they gain it through experience.
The shop staff basically are the shop. For example, whenever I am building a new type of prototype of anything, the first thing I do is literally go to every single shop staff person independently, because every single person in the shop has a different work experience background. Combining their collective knowledge and experience basically allows me to jumpstart the prototyping process.
I think what really sets our program apart is the intangible. It's the mentoring of the technical staff, their desire, their will to want to give back, want to take green engineers that maybe have never had a screwdriver in their hand before and show them this world of the physical.
They're very adamant that like the students are the ones doing the machining. They might show you one time and then say, okay, now you do it. And then you have your hands on the machine and you're turning the crank or you're changing the speed on the machine, rather than someone saying, this is how you do it, but then never giving you time to like actually try it for yourself.
All right, let's see what you got there.
Perfect. Wow, this one's right on.
All right. Okay. The one thing we do here is we train engineers. You guys are not going to be machinists. So we're training you how to make parts so that when you design parts, you have a really good concept of how stuff is manufactured. So you can design it so it's manufacturable for cost, time, and efficiency.
Whether or not you actually go on to do that on a daily basis, that experience changes the way you think. And when you go out and talk to someone like in a job interview setting, that definitively comes out.
I mean, the most interesting employees, the most interesting engineers, the most interesting educated individuals are those that can apply their knowledge in sort of unstructured environments where you're not sure exactly how the result is going to turn out.
It's one thing to have an abstract design and to be able to say, look, I designed this, but then it's just very satisfying. And it gives everything a purpose to be able to make that in real life and say like, hey, I thought of this. This was my concept, and now I have it in my hands. It kind of ties together the whole engineering thing.
I started out this semester not having machined anything pretty much ever. And by the end of it, we created this entire thing from scratch. Yeah. And it was really empowering and inspirational to go from sketches that we created to this thing that's tangible and works.
You know, like the digital divide, we're going to see a maker divide at some point.
It's what I think inspires a lot of these young engineers to really like, yes, I've made the right decision. Engineering is my field. It's something that they weren't expecting.
Because being able to physically build something is at the end of the day all that matters in the engineering workforce.